And now is the final matchup. We gotta make our way to Gaius Van Balthasar and fight him off all the way through. I don't believe we have to take an elevator.
Look for the lift's control panel. It'll be somewhere nearby. Take the lift down, and you should find yourself in the chamber of the Ultima Weapon.
Tell me, for whom do you fight? How very glib. And do you believe in Eorzea? Eorzea's unity is forged of falsehoods. Its city-states are built on deceit, and its faith is an instrument of deception. It is not but a cobweb of lies. To believe in Eorzea is to believe in nothing. In Eorzea, the beast tribes often summon gods to fight in their stead, though your comrades only rarely respond in kind. Which is strange, is it not? Are the 12 otherwise engaged? I was given to understand they were your protectors. If you truly believe them your guardians, why do you not repeat the trick that served you so well at Cartano and call them down? They will answer, so long as you lavish them with crystals and gorge them on ether. Your gods are no different from those of the beasts. Icons, everyone. Except but this, and you will see how Eorzea's faith is bleeding the land dry. Nor is this unknown to your masters, which prompts the question, why do they cling to these false deities? What drives even men of learning, even the great Louis Soir, to grovel at their feet? The answer? Your masters lack the strength to do otherwise. For the world of man to mean anything, man must own the world. To this end, he hath fought ever to raise himself through conflict, to grow rich through conquest. And when the dust of battle settles, it is ever the strong who dictate the fate of the weak. Single path is open to the infinite ruler, that of false worship, a path which leads to innovation and death. Only a man of power can rightly steer the course of civilization. And in this land of creeping mendacity, that one truth will prove its salvation. Come, champion of Eorzea, face me. Your defeat shall serve as proof of my readiness to rule. It is only right that I should take your realm, for none among you has the power to stop me.
Now we're fighting off with Gaius Van Balthasar. Let's do this. We'll go ahead and get on the side of him. Flank him up right now. I'm gonna go ahead and pop a burst as well. There we go. Very good. Actually, I should probably go ahead and use my ability to, there we go. I'm gonna build up all the grease lightning stacks and go ahead and burst them real quick. It's gonna be great. One more. Wonderful, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I like that. Let's go for this. Behind now. See if we can flank him. I don't see his radius of damage, so I'm gonna have to try to work with that as best I can. Let's go ahead and get out of the AoE real quick. I'm not sure if I should go wood or not, or should just go ahead and stand it. I don't think it's really gonna matter that much. Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and stand it. I'm gonna go ahead and set myself on fire. I'm sorry, he was ahead of time. Oh my god, he's already dead. This is what it's like running instances. It's so easy because everybody already knows the best strategies for it.
Allow me then, hero, to do that which you will not. To the true power of the Ultima Weapon.
And here's our final encounter with the Ultima Weapon. Oh my god, I'm actually really excited. A little nervous because I don't fully remember how it goes. We just kind of wing it, maybe? Oh god, alright, so stay away from any beams that it fires. That's probably the best thing to do right now. There we go. I'm gonna try to farm my rotation as best I can, but no promises, to be honest. Don't know if I'll do well or not. Okay, stay away from that beam. Okay, let's go behind it. Let's try to flank it. Good. Also, I need to put up a dot, don't I? I'm gonna pop a cooldown. I don't know exactly what's happening right now. I have no idea. Ooh. Now, this is actually gonna be challenging because it's like a full boss. So, I need to be on my top game if possible. I don't want to be lying on the floor the entire instance battle. There we go. Got hurt a little bit, but it's fine. Not a big video. Stay right behind the enemy. There we go. Beautiful, beautiful. Looks like we're doing alright. Okay, stay inside. The blue stuff is probably bad here. Don't want to stay on the outside. And it summons Titan and Garuda. Okay, so it actually summons Garuda, Titan, Ifrit in order to do damage. I did not remember that one bit. Oh, the things I relearn when I'm doing this dungeon again. There we go. Reapply the dot effect. Good. Flank from the side. Okay, stay away from the fire. Oh, probably stay away from the inside as well. Not sure what's happening here. Just hopefully soak the AoE damage. Okay, let's go ahead and do this here. Do some epic damage here. Good, good, good. And one more. Good, nice. Let's go on the flanking again. Let's save it from the fire. Fire's bad. Oh, we almost did it. Sweet! Oh my god, hell yeah. There we go.
But the Ultima weapon is all powerful. Why does my enemy still stand? Can her strength truly be so great?
It is the blessing of light that confounds you.
Lahabria.
Your foe acts under the protection of the crystal she bears.
So, this is what empowers her.
Beyond mortal limits. If you are to prevail, the Hammer of Darkness must needs be brought to bear upon the Shield of Light. And so it shall. For the Ultima weapon is host to a power of which you are as yet ignorant.
Speak plainly, Ascian.
The heart of Sabik. It is the weapon's core, an enigma whose surface even the vaunted scholars of ancient Alec failed to scratch. The magic within has lain dormant for eons.
Of what magic do you speak?
A spell without parallel. Ultima. I sought the life force of the primals for no other reason but to quicken the core. For the true power of the Ultima weapon lies within its now beating heart.
Lahabria. What have you done?
No more than was necessary for my god to be reborn.
Damn you, Ascian.
The hour is at hand. Behold but a sliver of my god's power. From the deepest pit of the seven hells to the very pinnacle of the heavens, the world shall tremble. Unleash Ultima!
Such devastation! This was not my intention!
Oh, Hydaelyn, it seems the task of keeping your champion alive has exhausted what strength you had left. Van Belzar, your enemy's shield is broken. The rest I leave to you.
We will speak later, Ascian. But first, I must deal with you. The question of who is mightier remains. Come! adventurer. Let us find the answer together.
And looks like it's still alive. Oh, this is the most epic freaking battle ever. If you look at the surrounding areas for us, right? I'm gonna go ahead and hide the UI for a little bit. If you look at all the surrounding areas around us, everything is literally destroyed and we are fighting for our lives here as best we can against a true ultimate weapon. Oh lord, this is gonna be really scourge. Okay, stay away from these things. Let's kill the matchstick pins, just to make it a little bit easier on everybody in that party. Good. There's probably no reason to kill her, but hey, whatever. I want to make sure I'm helping out as much as I can. Let's save it from that AoE as well, that's a really bad idea. We get the matchstick pin. Okay, or matchstick bit. Okay, something just fell. Something really big just fell. Oh shit. Careful. Thought something more is gonna fall. Careful. I'm gonna go ahead and back up and get the matchstick bit real quick. Kind of take care of them. Typically, rangers would be the best for taking care of these kind of things. But I'm gonna go ahead and take the brawn for now. There we go, beautiful. Nice. I'm gonna go ahead and make my way back to the ultimate weapon to do some more single target damage. Let the range take care of the adds if possible. Yep, another matchstick bit. Let's go ahead and take it out. Careful. Nice. And it disappeared for a little bit. Oh, jeez. Oh, there we go. There it is. The ultimate is casting. Oh, God. The ultimate is casting. I think we're just supposed to soak it? Or are we trying to kill it? Nope, never mind. We're trying to kill it. Jeez.
Heed me. The subjects of a weak ruler must needs look to a higher power for providence, and their dependence comes at a cost to the realm. The misguided elevate the frail, and the frail lead the people astray. Unless a man of power wrests control, the cycle will never be broken. You of all people must see the truth in this. You who have the strength to rule.
Pathetic. You boasted of unrivaled power. You were entrusted with the ultimate weapon. The ultimate magic. And still, you failed. So much for the glory of man. Growing imbalance afflicting the planet must be redressed. If it is permitted to worsen, the very laws of existence, both etheric and physical, will be warped beyond all recognition. Know you the root of this corruption? Hydaelyn. Like a parasite, she must be burned out if the planet is to recover. And not but the return of the one true god will ensure her complete excision. Yet, to pave the way for the Master's return, a chaotic confluence of untold proportions must needs be brought about. And that will necessitate the presence of the Primals. Needless to say, both you and your Scion accomplices cannot be suffered to interfere in this endeavor. You will not leave this place alive. It is past time your flame was extinguished, bringer of light.
And the final fight against La Habrea. This is... when I say this fight is epic, I literally mean this fight is actually one of the most epic things I've ever done, or anybody would ever do when playing this game. Not even kidding you, this is one of the most epic things ever. Go from one boss to another to another to another, it is just a giant brawl and I love it. Except gotta be really careful with La Habrea, or not really, because he is really fast, he's about to die really fast. I'm pretty sure he's supposed to have another phase here. There we go. Either that or he is supposed to die right now. Which I... That's it? Wow!
If thou wouldst pierce the shadows, make thee a blade of light.
What?
Thank you.
And we defeated. Okay, I gotta give it to Indica. Indica, I think, did pretty good so far in damage. Dragoons typically do a decent amount of damage. I mean, as a monk, I do alright, but I'm not that experienced as a monk right now, so I gotta give it to Indica. I should've given it to Alex, because Alex did get left out from a, portal, but an elevator at a certain point. I do kind of feel bad about that. Nevertheless, though, ladies and gentlemen, we defeated La Habre, we defeated the Ultimo Weapon, we defeated Gaius, and we defeated the entire freaking empire, or majority of the empire, of the Garlean rule. And the place is now burning, and it looks destroyed, and I kind of feel like we really messed things up. Hey, look at that. My character's all happy and cheery. I didn't even make her cheer. Did I make her cheer? When did I make her cheer? I have no idea, but apparently she's apparently Elliot is just, you know, happy as she can be. This entire ordeal is over. Honestly, like I said, I don't think I've ever had a more epic fight ever since this, and I really hope that they're gonna be, well, no, there's some parts in Heaven's World that are pretty epic, but this was like one of my favorite fights ever when I first played the game. And I gotta say, if you getting into Final Fantasy XIV yourself, experience this. This is worth it. Try not to be like me. Try to see if you can party up together with a free company or friends or something and run through this, you know, calmly and really experience the story. For me, I'm gonna have to rewatch everything through cinematics on the side, which kind of sucks on our own. Hey, at least I got player commendation. Looks like I did pretty good, you know? People were nice enough to, you know, say like, you know, you did all right.
And so my conquest ends, Cid. In smoke and ashes.
Here. Feel. Think. Warrior of Light, beloved daughter. The darkness hath fled before the unclosed brilliance of thy spirit. Yet it lingereth still beyond the sight of men, in forgotten corners of the world. In the depths of the abyss yet resideth the Dark One, watchful ever. Till this evil be cast out, never shall the world know aught but a passing peace. Yet for the present, a gentle light shineth o'er the realm of Eorzea. With thee at its heart. From sparkling moat shall it swell to glorious sun, and all the world shall bask in its warmth. Blessings and joy be upon thee. Go forth, my child, and be as a beacon of hope for Eorzea and the lands beyond through all the days of thy life.
My lady, all Twin Adder units have fallen back to the outer perimeter.
The Flames have completed their withdrawal, General.
Admiral, all hands accounted for.
She's still in there.
Sid, has there been no word?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Damnation!
She's going to make it, I know she is!
Ida is right. We must have faith.
Sid, can they not be evacuated aboard the Enterprise? That adventurer and the Scions are as the Warriors of Light reborn. We cannot abandon them to their fate. Not again.
I wholeheartedly agree, but flying into the midst of that would only add to the fireworks.
There must be something we can do.
Please, Mother Hydaelyn. Please light her way through the darkness.
Look into the light, my child. If thou would see thy companions returned safe to thee, reach out to them now.
There!
Oh!
Hydaelyn.
Welcome home.
You almost got us killed that one time, remember?
Now, we both know that was your fault.
Thank the 12, we're safe.
Mind your horns there, Manbull.
Mayhap when you mind your manners.
Though the crystal that bound Thancred is no more, I doubt we can say the same of Lahabrea. And even if we could, we know that he is not alone. Confounded Ascians. Their god may be unknown to us, but their zeal is unquestionable. Suffice it to say, it would be folly to assume that they no longer pose a threat. Nevertheless, for now, we must savor what peace we have won, however ephemeral. Do you see, Grandfather? Our first step towards realizing the dream for which you gave your life.
ends. The dread night of Imperial tyranny and Anassian machination is ended. A new day now begins in Eorzea.
True to their name, the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, along with our champion, have delivered us from darkness.
Let their shared victory serve to remind us of our shared history. And let their bravery in the face of adversity inspire future generations.
Doubt not, the realm will need bravery in the days to come. Old rifts threaten to divide us within our walls, while hordes of beastmen claw at our gates. And though the Black Wolf be slain, the rest of the pack remains. Yet no foe need we fear, so long as we stand as one.
So long as the Scions stand for peace.
So long as our champion stands fast. For there exists no adversity over which we may not jointly prevail.
No longer can we turn a blind eye to the suffering of our allies.
No nation stands alone. If one should fall, so shall we all. Eorzea is our shared home. For any one of us to know peace, so too must our neighbor.
Just as we join in solidarity before you this day, so too shall our grand companies be joined henceforth to strive not only for the good of mere nations, but for the good of all the realm.
Change will not come overnight. Yet I foresee a day, not so very far from now, when the lines that divide our lands fade, and all of Eorzea is one.
It has been but 5 short years since the Battle of Cartano. 5 years since the advent of the Seventh Umbral Era. No victory, however sweet, can wash away our bitter sorrows. No triumph can reclaim those we lost. Yet do not presume you honor them by dwelling on the past. It was not the past they fought for. You would repay their sacrifice by looking to the future.
A future united, as the Warriors of Light united in the Champion.
Now is the time for us to rise as one, bearing all of Eorzea on our shoulders.
5 years ago, Eorzea bore witness to the end of the Sixth Astral Era. Now, the Seventh Umbral Era draws to a close, yet we come together not to glory in its end, but to mark a new beginning.
Let it be writ that on this day, by the light of the crystal, Eorzea ushered in a new era. The Seventh Astral Era is come! And thus is ours a realm reborn!
What is it?
What was that?
That roar. It can't be.
Did you hear that?
There's no time to spare.
Where is it coming from?
Dread tidings! Chaos and carnage! It is an abomination! A primal! A primal has awakened!
Cast Bahamul, move.
One Azaz, move, star.
Fanza Lokpai ki had Haldorn Zul, Ukudorn. Star of Chemuv, the only cause that pours right ball.
And ladies and gentlemen, this is going to conclude, almost conclude, our adventures throughout A Realm Reborn. Coming up and everybody's here clapping for us. Oh my god, this is, oh my god, it's so cool. I love it. Also, first of all, I got to do something real quick. I realized that at a certain point during testing and during messing around with my game, I accidentally left the cutscene audio to Japanese. So I'm going to go ahead and apply that. There we go. So that I can go back and re-record everything dubbed in English. Simply because we've been going with the English dub throughout the entire time, so might as well just stick with it. Oh my god, this is so cool! Oh my god, this is like... Oh god, I know this is NPCs and everything, but I made so many memories of all these NPCs. Enter to the solo, let's go in. What you saw before was foreshadowing to things that are going to be coming up ahead in the storyline. One of them, I believe, is a story raid, which I don't know which, if I'll be able to do eventually. I might try to at a certain point. I believe that is the cause of Bahamut, where we actually get to fight freaking Bahamut. So that would be kind of cool to do. But for now, search for Minphilia and finish off the storyline. The Archons have conducted a preliminary investigation into the origin of the roar that rang out during the celebration. The findings strongly suggest that a new primal has appeared, a new one, never mind, maybe it's not Bahamut. The roar generated a distinctive wave pattern in the ether, a pattern observed only once before in history, 5 years ago to be precise. I should like to think it mere coincidence, yet we cannot discount the possibility. Well, I trust I need to say no more. Yep, it is Bahamut, confirmed. At great sacrifice, we have delivered Eorzea from the threat posed by the Empire and the Primals, and thereby secure peace. We cannot well allow the realm to be plunged into chaos once more. You have given your all for our cause, risking your life and limb on I know not how many occasions. Yet our struggle continues, and we need you now, no less than before. Damn it. Still, the most eloquent speech ever that I can't freaking read ever. I'm sorry. Please continue to stand with us, and together we shall safeguard the future of the realm, of this very star. Quest completed, and achievement, Warrior of Light. And we also got a mount, which I would like to actually show you, ladies and gents. This part over here with Mephilia, that's going to be for the next story, The Price of Principle. We could also check out all of the recurring problem. She needs our talents for redeeming Prime a problem, which we can do, I believe, a raid for. It's going to be a Bahamut raid. But before we do anything else, let me go ahead and walk out of the Walking Sands, show you all the mount. The mount, by the way, is a magic armor that we rescued from the Praetorium, the one that fought with us, the one that saved us, literally carried us out of there, us and Thancred. And I'm also glad that Thancred is back as well. The story is just gonna get more immense from here on out. It's gonna get better, it's gonna get bigger. Heavensward does so well, and I'm so excited for Stormblood as well. Oh my god, we got so much stuff to cover, and I couldn't be more excited than Jim, and I could not be more excited. This is gonna be freaking awesome. Let me go ahead and go outside though and show you the mount before we finish off. Hi Tataru, hi! How's it going? Let's go and pet real quick. There we go. There you go, Tataru. Just chill over there. You know, you're good. Good girl. Let's go ahead and put on the mount. There we go. Good. And mount guide and ta-da! We got a magic armor, and this thing actually also flies, so whenever we unlock flying over in... Oh, somebody else is also riding their own as well, that's kind of cool. Whenever we unlock flying in Heavensward areas, we'll be able to fly literally all over the place. It will take us a while to authenticate ourselves properly within the zones, and make sure we are properly tuned to the areas before we can fully fly there, and that'll require us to discover certain areas, do a certain main quest, side quest, stuff like that. But I'm gonna do every single last one of it all, because I want to make sure that we can fly in Eorzea and just in general have a good time. For now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up around here. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed while we're petting our we're petting our mech right now. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. My name is Tamriel. Like, subscribe, and as always, have a good day. And I'll see you all in the next episode of Final Fantasy XIV with more story going back into patch 2.1. There we go. That's the right one. Anyway, see ya. We'll be right back.